Hello everyone. In this lecture, let's try to understand how a timer works on interrupt overflow mode in our Atmega microcontrollers. Let's get started. So what is a timer? Timer is a peripheral of a microcontroller that is used for counting time. And some of the basic applications of timers are accurate time delay generation, measuring frequency of pulses, generating PWM signals, and triggering external devices or peripheral of its own microcontroller. And as I said, timer is actually a counter which counts time. There are two methods of counting. One is up counting and another one is down counting. So up counting is a method of counting from zero to pre-programmed value, and down counting is a method of counting from pre-programmed value to zero. And let's understand the working principle of timer in interrupt overflow mode. For that, initially we will assume the period value or pre-programmed value to be 5. And as the microcontroller starts, the timer also starts counting from the pre-programmed value, that is period. So here we have assumed the period to be 5, so the timer starts counting from 5 and it reaches 6, 7, 8 and it goes on till the maximum value. So this maximum value will be depending on the resolution of the timer. That is, it may be 8 bit timer or 16 bit timer. If it is an 8 bit timer, the value will be 2 power 8, which is nothing but 255. And if it is a 16 bit timer, the value will be 2 power 16, which is nothing but 65535. So once the timer reaches the maximum value, timer will roll over from its maximum value to the period value defined, that is nothing but 5. So again, once after the fall off timer occurs from the maximum value to the period value, the timer again starts counting from the period value to its maximum value, and again the timer falls over, and again the process continues in timer. So this process continues in timer until the timer module is stopped. So whenever the fall of the timer occurs from the maximum value to the period value, the timer module will generate an interrupt called timer overflow interrupt, which will interrupt the processor. So every time when the timer rollover happens from the maximum value to period value, this interrupt will interrupt the processor, and we can write an ISR function for executing a set of lines whenever this rollover of timer happens. So this is how timer works in timer overflow interrupt method. So once this event interrupts the processor, we can implement a set of codes written inside a ISR of timer overflow vector. So that we will see in the programming part. For now, you just remember that whenever timer rollover happens, the timer overflow interrupt will interrupt the processor. So this interrupt will be triggered again and again when the timer rollover from the maximum value to the period value. So until the timer is stopped, this interrupt will occur again and again when the timer rollover happens. So the timer clock is given by the formula system clock divided by prescaler. System clock is nothing but the clock of the microcontroller, and prescaler is nothing but a number that is used for reducing the frequency of timer. So let's take the minimum value of prescaler, that is 1. So now the timer clock will be equal to the system clock of the microcontroller. Let's take the system clock to be 16 megahertz, and timer period is given by 1 by 16 megahertz, that is equal to 62.5 nanoseconds. So this is the time period for one tick of the timer. That is nothing but the time gap over here. So when the timer clock is equal to 16 megahertz, this time gap is 62.5 nanoseconds, as we calculated here. So we will see the configuration part in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.